my form of Bible study formatting, even as you're watching this video, it would be important for you to take notes. It's very important that you take notes that you might be able to follow along with what I'll be speaking about when I speak about the Great Commission. Let's look at this just a little bit. The Great Commission. What is the Great Commission? Doesn't look like my marker is pretty good here. Let me try to underscore that with blue. All right. What is the Great Commission? What do you think the Great Commission is? Do you remember what you've heard preachers say that the Great Commission is? Preachers usually quote the Great Commission as found in Matthew chapter 28, verses 19 and 20. I'm going to turn to it right now, and hopefully that'll give you an idea, those of you that are not very familiar with what the Great Commission is, what it is. What it is basically is God's claim on our lives as he calls us to go out into the world that we live and to witness for him. If we're truly believers, we are commissioned to do something. And Jesus came and spoke unto them, saying, all authority has been given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the age. That's the Great Commission, or our particular call to go. So the first thing that we notice about this commission, that it is impossible to discuss the responsibility of you as a believer within the church fellowship today without emphasizing that our activity must take us outside of the church. It's impossible to discuss what our role is as believers if our role does not, as believers, take us outside the walls of the church, outside of where you are right now. Many people have this kind of mentality about the gospel, that since you've come to Christ, that everything that you're involved in is to be done within the church. That's not true. What Christ wants to do through you, through various levels of evangelism, he wants you to leave the church and make an impact on the communities that you live. Now, this impact can only be made by people that are willing to go out and become an impact themselves in the lives of others. Doesn't make any difference whether you're black. I think all my markers is kind of sketchy here. Doesn't make any difference whether you're white, okay, brown, yellow, pink, or red. Doesn't make any difference what color you are. Christ has commissioned us to lead the church and to go out and to evangelize in our world. That's what he's called us to do. Gene Getz, a Christian writer, put it this way. He says, believers need three vital experiences to grow into mature Christians. Believers need three vital experiences. The first experience that believers need is sound Bible teaching. Let me put that down. Sound Bible teaching. Do you agree with that? In other words, you're not going to be able to go out into the world and witness to anybody if you don't have a sound Bible teaching program in your church. It's of the utmost importance that you have a sound Bible teaching. So therefore, that's up to your pastor. And he is a pastor teacher. You know, a lot of people think that all pastors do is just get up and preach. That's a very small part of the ministry in the church. Getz was right. The second thing is that they require a deep and satisfying relationship both with each other and with Jesus. In other words, there must be a relationship with each other and with Jesus. See, there isn't going to be any type of witnessing process if you don't have a relationship with me, and if I don't have a relationship with you, and if either of us do not have a relationship with Jesus Christ. There must be that deepening relationship with Christ. If that doesn't exist, and if this doesn't exist through a good Bible pastor teacher training program, well, that's going to hinder you. And the third thing that he says is they need to experience seeing people come to Christ, seeing people come to Christ as a result of corporate and individual witness in the non-Christian world. In other words, they've got to see results of evangelism. If you don't see any physical results of evangelism, if you do not have a relationship with others and with Jesus, if you do not have sound Bible teaching through a good pastor, teacher, or a teaching staff in your church, it is most likely to understand that nothing will be done in a positive way in terms of evangelism through your church. Without these three vital things, there will be no reaching out to the community that God has called you to reach out to. And I think that that's of the utmost importance. As we discuss evangelism or the Great Commission, and I hope that you took those notes down. It's very important that you take those notes down, because as we discuss this evangelism now, for the rest of our period of time of study here, without those three factors, and I may ask you about that as we review this, but without those particular three factors, you might not be very successful. We are in the world to bear witness of the grace of God in Jesus Christ. That's why we're here. We're placed in the world to bear witness to what Christ has done in our lives. Now, if one of you is in the room, I want you to turn to 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. Just one of you. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9. Now, I have it right here in my Bible, and as you turn to it right there, we're going to give you a chance to read that verse. But as I said again, we're in the world to bear witness. We're in the world to bear witness to other people about what Jesus Christ means in our lives. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put the video on pause, and I want one of you to read that particular verse of Scripture in 1 Peter 2 and 9 right now.
Right.